you're out here playing Survivor, Survivor Barbie. That is the last thing that you want to be coined as. I'm not afraid to fill those shoes because I know I can. But in my head, not necessarily a positive connotation. I'm going to have to prove them all wrong that, you know what, I'm not a weakling. I'm very competitive. I can do it. But I still think it's an uphill battle for me.
How did you feel about last night?
Oh, it's always brutal, but it was the, I mean, it was the majority. It was the plan, so.
Do you have any in mind who you would want to?
Gosh.
You know, I really didn't realize we were as dysfunctional as we were when we went to tribal council, because I actually genuinely get along with every single person in this tribe. I really like every single person. And apparently, I'm the only one that gets along with everybody for whatever reason.
I think we should definitely see how today goes before we start discussing this.
Well, today's just a reward, I hope.
It was brutal going to tribal council. We don't want to go back, period. So, you know, hopefully we're going to get it together.
Make sure you don't hit it.
Mick had thrown those last two balls so close to the stick. My goal was to, like, not even get close to him because I didn't want to mess anything up. Russell and I have talked about since the first day about being the final two at the end. So at this point, I'm kind of his wingman, I guess you could say.
I'm good for now. I know what I need to know.
You're good for a long while.
Hopefully we'll start winning.
I definitely think people underestimate me, and I want them to think that, hey, it's really smart for them to take me to the end because they could beat me. You know, use that to my advantage. And if it comes down to me or him, I know I could beat Russell in the very end, because I would say a lot of other people in the tribe have really been rubbed the wrong way by him. So I'm just trying to not ruffle feathers, steer clear, build good relationships, which is what I'm good at.
This is great.
You got it made, I'm telling you.
After the challenge, Ashley felt horrible that, you know, she felt like it was her fault. But you know what? We're kind of like sisters. So we've kind of been able to talk each other through that and encourage each other. So, you know, I just want to make her feel better about it.
I hope I can pick you up and,
yeah.
I mean, you're strong and you've done well. You've done really, really well. I'm really proud of you.
We're all stuck in this shelter, confined in a little ball. So I don't know what everybody's decision is going to be. But I think it's gonna be one of us girls for sure.
Like, at first, I thought these hermit crabs are great.
The night before the merge, Jason, Russell, myself, and Mick had all kind of talked and chatted about who we needed to get to know, who we needed to talk to. Yeah, I mean, I knew that I wanted to meet the girls because it was supposed to be kind of like an underlying girl alliance, possibly. It was important for all of us to kind of get to know the certain ones, but more importantly, trying to figure out who was going to budge and who wasn't.
It's our kitchen.
The glue camp. I love it. It's awesome. I feel like I'm at the Hilton. You know, at Foa Foa, we had absolutely nothing. Here at Glue, there's blankets, pillows. Everybody, it really seems like a family.
I'll show you where our water and stuff is.
Okay. Laura kind of took me under her wing. She was kind of like mother hen, showing me around. And it was really nice because it was really important for me to talk to Laura to find cracks in this group. Make no mistake, there are cracks. It's just, are there enough cracks and big enough cracks to get the numbers on our side?
Think of it this way, Blue still has plenty of people. Plenty. I'm telling you, y'all, he is gonna wreak havoc.
Kelly and Laura, I just basically let them know that Eric needed to go now. We have four people, they have eight. It's not a big deal if they lose one. I'm definitely putting my faith in Laura and Kelly, and I'm just gonna hope that it works.
He's gotta go.
What?
Oh my God. That was perfect.
I'm just actually trying to take it easy, not ruffle any feathers, and just kinda observe. I've been sleeping in the shelter with Laura, Monica, trying to keep a little eye on that little group, but there may be a little bit of room for split there. At this point, I don't think I can trust Laura. I think she's definitely here to play the game, and just based off the way I've seen her treat Shambo, even though I really like her, I know that she could treat me the same way. So yeah, my guard's up, definitely, with her.
I can believe you played it.
Well, because I wanted, we needed to make him nervous.
Oh my word, no doubt.
I kind of went out for a walk and I stumble upon this rat or this mouse. I'm so scared. Oh my gosh, a rock or a stick. A rock or a stick. I really could, oh my gosh. I'm like, oh my goodness, that's like something to eat. I was just thinking, I'm starving. I never thought I'd be this hungry in my life.
Oh gosh, okay, just turn around, eat your snack. Eat your snack, eat your snack. Eat your snack, buddy. Oh gosh, oh my word. Oh, I'm sorry. Oh, this is pitiful. Oh my gosh. Oh Lord, have mercy. Oh my word. Okay.
Finally, I just hit the rat. It was really hard for me because he was looking at me. He was cute. But I knew how I'm starving. I've never been this hungry in my entire life. I feel like I'm just fading away. It felt really good to contribute to a team that won. And I'll tell you, the reward was absolutely amazing. I feel like it was definitely well-deserved. I was hanging out of that cradle. You know, that was more my thing. I was just kind of hanging out of it, grabbing the flags. At probably day 12, I was thinking, what have I done? Why did I like give my job up? Like, I'm insane. But I was like, you know what? I'm gonna try to keep a good attitude and just try to make the best of it. Oh my goodness, finally day 26, I get to go on a reward and I needed the food. I literally was like wasting away.
Oh my gosh, try that pie.
It felt just like home. It was really, really nice. I just felt really thankful to have gotten to go.
Thank you for allowing me and Russell to come on our first reward.
Wow, Miss. Congratulations.
I was like, oh my word. The shower was amazing.
Goodness.
It felt so good to put soap on my body, shampoo my hair. The only problem was I ran out of water and I'm like lathered up my whole body. I had already rinsed out the shampoo out of my hair, but I had tons of conditioner. Still have tons of conditioner in my hair right now, which is totally
next
fine.
Next item.
So we can get me, you, some go get rid of any purchase when it's time comes. And then that eliminates the threat on you. I think way ahead of time.
It feels really good to be aligned with Russell. I mean, he is the most powerful player in this game. He knows that whatever he votes, I vote too. So really, he's got two votes no matter what, any way he wants to play it. It may, you know, mess me up in the end, but I've made it this far. So, you know, I'm just gonna trust him and we'll go with it. And I'm hoping that I'll be in the final two. Russell and I are two that you'd probably never put together in a million years. But you know, it's from the first day that we've been aligned. We're still kicking. But yeah, Russell and I, we feed each other information. He doesn't tell me everything because he knows I don't want to lie to anybody and he doesn't want to put me in an uncomfortable situation, but he'll just say, trust me, trust me, trust me. I've got it under control, but you know, that's all I have to go off of. It's my only shot and I'm gonna go with it.
That you may be filled to the measure of all with the fullness of God. Ephesians 3:16-19.
That's good.
Oh my gosh, Brett is an absolute sweetheart. I mean, Brett and I have had several discussions about the Bible and about some Christian books. I've really enjoyed that, so it's been nice to have that in common. Brett and Mick and myself, we just decided today we're gonna have good attitudes and we really just enjoyed each other and I like Mick and Brett a whole lot.
Take a bag.
I'm just putting them up here.
Okay. Brett's an amazing person. If I have to be standing next to a galoo, you know, Brett is awesome. But I've been in with Russell since the very first day. Honestly, it's the hardest thing to balance your heart and your head as far as strategically and then what your heart's telling you. It is so tough. So, you know, hopefully my mind is thinking clear enough to look at the end to be able to win the game. Russell knows that, you know, I'm very trustworthy and anything that goes on, he'll know about. When I was a captain and Russell was a captain, it was definitely strategic when I was picking because Brett is a huge threat. So I knew that he needed to be on my team because he's not going to sway me and where I'm going with my vote. Not only that, I knew I needed to pick Mick as well because I feel like if we did win reward, Mick would be fed and Brett would be fed. And I think that Mick would have a good chance to beat Brett at the next immunity, which is what we want. It was very strategic when I picked the teams, absolutely.
You had no doubt in your mind, I hope. When I first
I had to think a little bit.
Russell, from the very first day, he told me, I'll take you to the final two if I can trust you. And I was like, you can trust me. I've been completely honest with him, letting him know what's going on. And we've kind of been on the same page with everything. So we actually have quite a bit of power. Two brains are better than one.
Could possibly beat him, and then it's back to the normal plan.
If not, though, you think I'm going?
Probably so.
You know, my whole goal coming into this game was to play the underdog, be underestimated, and just kind of slide through, which is what I've done, and it's gotten me this far.
We all know what has to happen. Sometimes you gotta go for it. And that's what I'm gonna do.
You know, Russell and I had always planned to be in the top, but unfortunately, they want to beat Brett so bad at the next immunity challenge that, you know, there's honestly probably no way that I could beat Brett. It is absolutely the worst feeling to have to go to tribal council tonight. All four of us Fo'afo'a have been so tight, loyal, and trustworthy to this point. We have no other glue to pick off. I mean, Brett won immunity. There is no other option. Fo'afo'a has to go home. And I definitely feel like my head's on the chopping block, clearly, because I'm the weakest one. I'm hanging by a thread.
Plan was the same this morning, right, when we left?
Yeah, Mick, if Brett wins.
Double check with Russell, have you talked to him?
Russell, myself, and Mick are all voting for Jason. As far as I know, Jason is voting for Mick and thinks that everybody's voting for Mick. So I did not want to have to face Jason at this point in time. But unfortunately, I mean, I got stuck. So it was uncomfortable, it was awkward.
I kept trying to tell him, go talk to Russell, go talk to Russell. I didn't want to have to lie to him.
Don't make me make you look stupid on the jury. This game ain't over, girl. I'll put you in the jury.
Ease up. Please.
I think there may be a little bit of strategy involved to Russell making us feel like we're not going to win or that we don't have a chance, but I have news for him. I'm not going to give up, and I'll just explain to the jury, I don't work the same way as Russell. That would clearly not have worked for me. The girls that were aggressive, they got eliminated early. My strategy was to be myself, and at the end of the day, you know, I wasn't out to get anybody or make anybody look bad. Russell made it clear he was okay with making people look bad. It feels really good to be the last girl standing. I'm just in shock, honestly, that I'm still here. Not only am I here on day 39, Mick, Russell, and myself have beat out 17 other people to be here on the last day, and it feels so good. I feel like I got a once-in-a-lifetime opportunity, and I'm extremely appreciative for it.